Hello.
Hello and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X. I'm back. I've had some ISP issues and I've upgraded as well. So we shall see what we shall see. So what is my triumphant return? Well, it's not all that brilliant. And Space Engineers is off to a great start by telling me there's a controller error. This is a bug that happens now and then with the console version of the game. I'm not sure about the PlayStation, but it's been happening once or twice on the Xbox version. I'm sure it'll get fixed down the line, but where was I? Power. Wind power. I've seen a lot of people talking about it, asking about it, and I've gone through and talked about solar, I've talked about the reactor, I've talked about wind. But what I haven't really talked about in any great depth or detail is the optimization for your wind turbines on a planet with an atmosphere. This is where this comes in. See, if you put your wind turbine one block off the ground, you're going to get, if we look at the wind turbine, a poor wind clearance. Now, wind clearance is important for wind turbines, the same as you shouldn't build wind turbines too close together on the horizontal or the vertical. And this little demonstration here gives you an idea of the different types of output that you'll get from a wind turbine. Now, there's nothing wrong if you've got a really low powered system here by using one wind turbine. In fact, you can probably see that I've used one wind turbine here to sort of power my little light system that I showed you last time that turns the lights on and off. You remember it. Anyway, so you can have these things run by one or two wind turbines. If you're going for something bigger, like this drill rig over here that we built, then the tower of power, or the upgraded tower of power, where you ignore putting the top turbine in and you just build up the requisite number of blocks. Until you reach there, and then you put another block, and then you basically build a second tower of power. An hour, two blocks here again, still gives us a poor wind clearance. Three blocks. Now we're getting a good wind clearance. So three blocks up plus the turbine off the ground, we get a good clearance. Still not optimal. Another good clearance at four. And you'll find that around five as well will be clearance on good. However, 6, 7 and 8, and you might wonder why I missed out on the others. Well, seven is giving you a good, 8 is giving you optimal. So 8 blocks off the surface here with the wind turbine at the top, 9 blocks in total. That's a good optimal wind clearance. Want it better? Take it up to 11, take it up to 12. You'll start to see optimal wind clearances. So I often say 12 to 13 blocks in an area like this, and you have to bear in mind where you're going to be. If there's any kind of mountains or hills around, like on Earth-like or whatever, then you're going to want to put them high, 15, 16 blocks maybe, 17. And you've got the tower of power. And these are all giving optimal clearance. And as I said before, to get the double tower, don't bother with the top turbine. So just come up about 4 or 5 blocks from where you would put the top turbine and start building your tower of power. Pop your turbine on the top and you can go up again if you want. It just means you're not doing what I was doing over here and constantly building little towers of power everywhere on the same base. You can power everything from one tower. Yes, it's tall and so on, but if space is at a premium, that's a good thing to do, and it provides a good chunk of power to the whole system. And gives you optimal wind clearance. The other thing that I often see people say is that wind turbines don't work on a moving grid. Well, they do, as long as you have landing gear like this or whatever. I have to excuse the controller error bug again. It's just something I have to live with for a bit. And as I say, the landing pads, as long as they are connected to the ground, your turbines will function. To provide power to a moving grid. Especially, where's my, is it over here? A rather large, funky friend here. actually. There it is. Don't know if it'll let me build. Ah, there we go. Probably don't want to build it on. Actually, no, that should do it. Don't want this to drop like a stone. Sometimes it doesn't work on these kind of grids because it's attached to a piston and there's some grids. So what you'd need to do is you'd need to put it on a block that is actually attached to the main grid. So give me a moment just to poke around here. Let's just get rid of that. So yeah. That is not going to work on anything. Let me just see if I can build a little tower. It has to be on the main grid is what I was trying to demonstrate. There. So I thought it wouldn't work on the piston because the piston is a subgrid. So you can't do a system on a ship where you have wind turbines come up out of the ship on a piston, because it just won't work. You've got to do it like this. And you'll see that the turbine slows up when we come off the ground, and the turbine will start up again when we pop this back on the ground and lock the landing gear. So that's something to bear in mind if you're going to do a mobile grid like that one over there. Make sure that your wind turbines are not connected to a subgrid. They have to be on the main grid of the ship or the vessel in question. And there we go. That is really all I wanted to talk about in terms of turbines and wind power, is give yourself a decent clearance. Give yourself at least 12, 13, depending on where you are. Higher if needs be. Take it up 20 blocks, then stick the turbine tower of power on the top, like this. And you'll have no problems with wind clearance. You may find that certain planets do change the output of the turbines on a blizzard, on Triton I think it is, that they will start producing power, less power on there because the blizzard slows down the turbine blades. And on Pertum, it really helps. If a dust storm kicks off, it will boost the turbines. And the good news is, in the settings of the game now, you can actually turn weather damage off, so lightning no longer destroys your base, so you can actually enjoy the glories of a Pertum full-on lightning dust storm without the danger, if you want to do that. Otherwise, you're building these little lightning rods with decoys and welders, which will attract the lightning and prevent your base from being blasted. However, they have, I think it's a 50 meter radius or something like that before you have to build another one. So you have to build them in key strategic locations for your base. Anyway, that's really all I wanted to talk about. That's all I am going to do with this particular video. I don't want to stretch it too much since I've got nothing else to say in that regard. So stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. I will be back in the next one where we will look at that vehicle that I made over there, and I'll show you how to build it, because this thing actually mines along using that piston when the cargo box is full. It will retract everything, and it's not quite fully automatic since you still have to fly it, but it will mine automatically and then reset itself using a combination of the event controllers and some timer blocks and things like that. Until then though, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game, and I will catch you absolutely in the next one. It's good to be back. Bye for now.